Do you want to go in the living room?
No.
It's a dog warden. Do you want to actually...
Come on, Jennifer. Don't make any worse.
No. They've got to go.
No,
listen. When all these people have gone, I'll sit down with my colleague and we'll sort out how you can get your dogs back. Right? They won't be harmed at all. Don't worry about your dogs being harmed. They will be looked after.
Jennifer, don't
get
any worse.
Ashley, my dog's alive!
Just calm down.
Come and sit down.
Don't I want a bag!
All right. We'll sit down afterwards and we'll see if we can get the dogs back for you. All right.
Don't keep coming up
worse. Come in here. Come on, Jennifer. Let's have a chat. Come on.
Go and have a look at the paperwork the lady's got for you, Jennifer, yeah?
Oh, my God. Look, we're going to get something from you, I'm telling you. Right? Oh, it's great. It's just all full of gnats and flies and maggots. Oh, it's just... I don't know, it's just bags of shit here. And as you see, condoms and everything's here. What's happened? They've had a fight, they've set light to it where they can't get rid of no more rubbish because the chutes are blocked. And then they've just set light to it to try and make a bit of room for another load of shit that popped down here. Oh, that is full of human shit in the bag. And just slung it out raw. Oh, what's that? It's all full of piss, that is. Don't just stand there, please. Will you watch for people going by? I think this is now either the fifth or sixth occasion that this has been cleaned. Oh, can you believe that they live like this, eh?
Lots of times
before. Come and sit
down. Is this candy? Good girl. Happy girl. Good girl. Good girl. Happy girl.
Happy girl.
They're going somewhere where they'll be looked after. You didn't believe that it would come to this, did you? And we tried to tell you that it would. We told you not to get any more, didn't we?
You're right, Jen.
Jennifer, when the dogs are gone, there's some pest control coming in to spray for the smell, okay?
You won't
even
smell that.
Don't let them see
it.
You don't want to be upset.
Come on, come on. Oh, nice, darling. Here you go.
The balconies are sparkling on all sides, but the ground floor is another matter.
These bags are absolutely running alive with maggots, flies, insects. There's all sorts there. I mean, I don't know what is there, but rotting meat in there. There's everything you can think of. As you see, there's condoms, all used condoms and everything there. And it's, you know, getting guys up there, I think they need a medal for doing it. I mean, you can see from the start to finish what a mess it was when we started and the hard work the boys have put in. And you've seen the end result and just, you know, see how long it takes to get back to this. Won't take very long, about 2 to 3 weeks. If you'd like to come back in 2 to 3 weeks, you can film it all again.
Loretta's back at the crack house with the council's clinical waste team.
It's going to take the balls off the window, so you should be able to see quite a bit. It's quite light in there anyway, isn't it, with just a door. We actually saw needles in the bathroom.
Yeah.
There's definitely needles in the bathroom.
Uh-huh.
I can't remember where else we... I think we found some in the living room.
Yeah.
And just have a drug paraphernalia, sort of tinfoil and plastic bottles used as smoking pipe and such.
Once it's been out in the open, the blood is dead.
So you've got, there's a very, very chance of catching anything. But there's always that possibility, but there you are. They do get in a hell of a state when they can't get hold of it. That's the point. I mean, I've seen actually people really crying because they can't.
They're in pain, aren't they?
They're in pain.
Actually in pain.
Well, I mean, you don't know whether they could be in them cushions or anything, do you, really?
That's right. They normally pop down the side of the settee, so as soon as you open that, the needle pops out.
They reckon that in each London borough, 1,000 people a year are treated for drug abuse, and Tower Hamlets is no exception.
It's disgusting. Mm. And they're only young kids.
I know they are.
Young kids.
But we need to know it's where terrible. They've gone, because obviously, with the help of the police, we shut that one down.
It's terrible, Randy.
It is. It's scary.
It is scary.
And you feel very vulnerable. Yeah. And we appreciate that. Let us know if they get back in. Yeah.
Look through the rest of the property to see if you've got
clean
any
it up. No, see if there's any other cats.
Alright, that's what I'm going to do now.
Yeah. Right, start in that back bedroom.
Oh, we've got a cat litter tray. Hello, darling. What a surprise. There's a kitten.
Ah. And that is being sold. Someone is taking that today.
Yes, yeah, someone
is coming up
today.
For it.
She's selling it for £30.
Well, look, once we've basketed that one, I'll have
shit all over that carpet.
I'm pretty satisfied. There's nothing else in this room. I think we've got two more bedrooms to check.
Tim Stevens waits patiently in the wings with colleague Dave Haywood.
Oh, the smell.
Yeah, is this a dog's bed? This must have been a little Yorkie's bed, mustn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
You can smell it coming out the door now. It's not very pleasant. So I guess, yeah, you can appreciate where all the other residents are coming from here, and they're justified in their complaint, I think.
I'm going to get away to the vets with what we've got now, then. Okay.
Do you want to send Tim and Oliver? Do you want to come and do your spray when you're ready?
Yeah.
At the crack house, the needles have all gone. And here are the lucky fellas who'll complete the clear out.
Charlie, you done all the needles?
He's done them in here.
I've done them in there.
You've done them, so we're starting this room, yeah?
We have been quite concerned that the crackheads will get back in here again. My main concern is just to get it looking so it's habitable again, so that we can get a prospective tenant in here and get someone to have it as their home. Took his board.
That's for his window. Excuse me. That's for the window. I tried to chase you. I was chasing you out.
You gonna toilet in here? I think it is it? I think it's in the back.
No, it's the dogs, I think, smelling.
The animal pound has 5 more visitors. The vet's name is Willie Wildgoose.
If you could check it over and vaccinate it, please. Thank you.
We've taken all those animals away and they will be looked after while we go to court to get an order to keep them and rehome them.
This one's pretty old. Its teeth are in rather poor condition. Some of them look as if they're infected and loose. The left eye is missing. It's like there's a small surgical scar right in the middle there.
But I have to say that as from today, you have got to pay for the boarding of all those animals. We are also having to prepare a case to prosecute you for not complying with that notice. There's a maximum fine of £5,000 for that. This is serious, Jennifer. We tried to tell you so many times.
Over on the side. Here we go.
Good girl. Good girl, steady.
Here we are. Mm.
Good girl.
So, see, the most obvious thing here is that she's got a tumour that's about 3 or 4 centimetres in diameter here, affecting one of the teats. There's obviously a type of breast cancer. It may well be something that could spread to other parts of the body.
This is big trouble now, Jennifer, and it's going to cost a lot. Council's going to be coming to you for the money for the boarding. You're going to get taken to court. You need to seek legal advice now. OK? That's a letter explaining what we've done tonight. I'm sorry it had to be done. I'll leave you to think about it now. You know where you can contact me to talk about it. Thank you.
Thank you.
They're in pretty good nick. They've not been mistreated. They're well fed, aren't they, Mr. Walkers?
They seem to have been fed fairly well. This one is probably slightly thinner than the others, but she's certainly not at a point where I'd say she's underweight or been underfed in any respect at all. Okay,
thanks ever so much for that. That went really well. That enabled us to do what we needed to do.
No, that's great. That's great. We can enjoy the rest of the day now, can't we?
I think it went
well.
Really, really well.
I did, yeah.
It's like clockwork.
It was, yeah, the dogs were out. And
dogs were out with hardly a bark. There's no point actually telling her anything in words. You have to tell her by actions. Mm, and I think that's what we've done today.
They'll go off for kennelling and they'll be settled down. And a decision will be made at a later date about their long-term welfare.
They've spent over £9,000 on the crack house, but it still needs a hard sell.
Everything in here is new. New work surfaces, the same with that cupboard that's been painted, new units, OK? The windows will be reglazed.
Why is this?
This is how they have to screw them in, and they have to. It's just they have to break them. Otherwise, people will get in. And then we then can't let it, and it will get into the state that it was in before, from people getting in here when they wasn't allowed to be in here. So that's why. But the windows will be replaced. I'll take you through to the living room. Okay, it's been fully decorated, all new flooring. I think we've done a really good job, considering what it was like. Haven't said to you there wasn't a problem with this flat. We have had a problem. There was people in here that wasn't allowed to be in here, so we got them out. And once we got them out, before they'd gone, this is what they did. Not at all. No, they're not. Not at all. They're not back at all. They're not. And if they was, they would be in here by now. They would be back by now. And we've had it empty for a long, long time. I mean, this will be your home, and your home is what you make it. It's security for your little child, and it's security for you as well.
Jennifer's dogs went to a foster home. A week later, she signed them over to the council, and the threat of prosecution was withdrawn.
Can you go now and come back when tomorrow sometime?
Her neighbours can breathe easy once more.
Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful
Killers 2.